I'm a capital remandee, and first of all, I'll have to acknowledge that being in prison is not an easy thing. And prior to my coming in prison, I was a student. Though I was a student, I happened to be to have a fiancé somewhere. One time he just came. I was expectant by then, 8 months. He just came into the house, started beating me up. And then by the time I asked, he threw a knife at me, which injured my right hand. And being a tempered person in self-defense, I took the knife and I stabbed him several times, and he passed. Okay, naturally, I'm a short-tempered person. So when he came, he first of all threw me. I knocked at the wall. So I injured my left knee. Then he took the knife. He threw it at me, and it cut my hand. So I was like, Kwani, this guy want to resign me, or what is up? So I just took the knife in self-defense, because actually I was strangling me by then, and I stabbed him, first of all, here. Then the next time, it added on his left side part, and several others. I was absolutely not in control of myself, because I just remember the first thing, I just held my head like this. Then the first thing I saw was a 1 liter bottle of Coke, empty. So I just said, if I knock him with this, he won't feel pain. So I saw a stool there, and I was like, no, this won't hurt him the way I want. So I just remember I just held my head like this, and when I turned around, I saw the knife. And I don't remember whether I closed my eyes, or, but I just remember I saw something dark. And that's when I took the knife and I stabbed him several times. I just felt bad, because actually this is a person I loved. First of all, I'm carrying his child. So that means the child that I'm carrying will never live to see his biological father. And it hurts me up to date.
Beatrice recalls how resentful she felt upon arrival at Langata Women's Prison.
But once I came here, at first I was very, very, very bitter. So my first reaction was like, okay, I just pray to God that I go home and I'm going to revenge. Man, I used to say that I'm going home, join a cult, and then I'll just kill the whole of their family, all of them. But that year in December, there was a fellowship there in the remand, and I gave my life to Christ.
In prison, Beatrice has a lot to deal with, including seeking acceptance from fellow inmates.
First of all, the capital remand is, we are feared. We are feared. Any going somewhere, and then, like, for instance, in court, I'm going to court, and then everybody is like, oh, she's a capital remandee. So imagine I'm going to court, and there's a warden behind me holding a gun. Then you're like, God, what's up? Anyway, it just feels bad. Being a capital remandee, it's hard, and then everybody sees you like the worst person ever. But anyway, being in prison generally is just hard. It's just hard. And more so, living in such a place where you just believe that everyone who is here is a criminal, and they don't realize that there are some of us who are here, they are not criminals, but we are victims. Like myself, I do not consider myself as a criminal, I consider myself as a victim. Because that was the day that I just believed that, were it not for God, I would have died that very same day.
As I talk to Beatrice, I can't fail but notice a constant smile on her face. This is unusual for anyone in her position.
Okay, I'm motivated by the fact knowing that these are the circumstances that I'm facing today. The situation that I am in today, it's not permanent. I just take it as a phase of life, of which I have to pass through and then just be a new person. A phase like the way that you just mature from one stage to the other. I just believe that my coming to this place, it was purposed. It was not incidental or accidentary. It was purposed by God himself. Because I've learned so much here, and I just believe that soon I'll be a free person. And what makes me happy is that today I'm imprisoned here, but my spirit is free. I got a friend. She works with Faraja. She's Christine Odero. She has been afraid indeed. She teaches me the word of God, has helped me step out of denial, to accept everything, not to fix myself, but to face the realities of life which comes my way. She has helped me, but now I was like, oh no, Christine, now you're telling me that I have to grow spiritually. How? Then she said, just choose a church. Just choose a church, the one that will. Okay, the first baptism I was there, then I was like, no, I don't want to be baptized. Let me just pray about the whole thing. Then the second time I just said, no, I won't go there. Let me just pray. Just pray for the right time to come. And I just believe today was the right day for me to be baptized. And I believe God has a plan and a purpose for my life, because I believe right now, I'm sure if Jesus comes right now, I would go to heaven. I would just believe that I would go to heaven. And I believe, though the going has been rough, I just believe that from now onwards, I'll be able to help people just like I do. I teach people every Friday in the evening. In the afternoon, we have a CU meeting where we gather with people. I teach them the word of God, and I have seen many give their lives to Christ. yani, become new people. Yani, you see someone has changed. But the thing that I'm struggling with right now, they are afraid of mine. I love them so much. And this is a prayer request I'm praising before each and every one of you. I have friends, and they are so young, 20 years and below. We are with them, Capital Remandees, but they are drug addicts. I'm trying to help them realize that the more you use the drugs, it doesn't help you solve the problem. Actually, it postpones the problem. You'll never get a solution by the same. Because fine, one day they'll get a lot of bang and then you'll just smoke it and you'll be high for the next 3 hours and so. But after there, the pain is still there, so fresh in you. What will you do about it? The only thing is to deal with it and just let God treat. And everybody's like, hey, wanakujanga tu jela wanaokoka for survival. But I believe my salvation is not for survival in prison. It's just something that I'll carry out there.